Today, I will take you on a unique trip from Madrid to Gijón on board the controversial Talgo Avril. Is it all that bad? I will show you how it feels to travel on this brand new train, the interiors, scenery, and, of course, the gauge and tension-changing facilities. Come along! Hola y bienvenidos a Madrid Chamartín. Hi and welcome to Madrid Chamartín, a station transformed into a construction yard that, once completed, will turn Chamartín into one of the most beautiful modern stations in Europe. During this construction phase, the passenger space is heavily reduced, causing severe crowding in all areas of the building on days like today. Additionally, all passenger amenities are temporary. However, this does not prevent Adif, the infrastructure manager, and the train operators from providing a still acceptable level of service. It is challenging to completely refurbish a train station while maintaining the trains and all services running. Adif is somehow reasonably managing to do this, which is commendable. Renfe's club lounge, located after security control, is available for AVE passengers with premium fares. Is it quieter than the rest of the station? Yes, indeed it is, and it offers snacks, drinks, and reading materials to make the wait more comfortable. Stylish, modern, and functional, it's a much more pleasant alternative to waiting for trains than the main concourse. Please note the apple baskets placed in various locations, adding a nice and healthy touch to otherwise bare tables. There's even a conference area that can be closed, creating a comfortable workspace while waiting to board the trains. And that's exactly what I'm going to do now. See the passengers standing in the shade waiting for ticket control? It's over 40 degrees Celsius today. Remember this detail, it will become important later in the video. Let's settle in for departure at 4:43 PM with a 6-minute delay. Later, I'll give you a detailed tour of the interiors. As for right now, let's take a look at today's trip map. From Madrid to Gijón, it's a total distance of 491 kilometers, scheduled to be covered in 3 hours and 34 minutes. From Madrid to León, 345 kilometers in 2 hours, using the high-speed international gauge lines at speeds of up to 300 kilometers per hour. And from León to Gijón, 146 kilometers in 1 hour and 35 minutes, using the new Pajares variant and the conventional line in Iberian gauge at speeds of up to 200 kilometers per hour. Shortly after departure from Chamartín, on the left side of the train, there's the Fuencarral railway complex, where Renfe, several other companies and assorted service providers have established their workshops. Here, all levels of maintenance are provided for different rolling stock classes, diesel and electric, both in international and Iberian gauges. It's also at this major complex that Renfe is refurbishing and making ready for re-entry into service 6 class 490 tilting trains, which have been out of service since 2014 and are expected to re-enter commercial service in 2025. Back inside the train, let's take a look at my not-so-comfortable seat. No amount of reclining can make it as good as the seats on other trains, including other Talgos. It's also incomprehensible the lack of USB ports on brand new trains, other than the one poorly located under the screen. The legroom is quite generous, which is a positive aspect of this train. The moving map is a welcome feature, but the onboard entertainment in general is quite lacking. There are only 7 movies available, with no music, books or games loaded into the system. Additionally, there's information about the toilets, general trivia about the trains, and some details about the catering and screen configuration. On the lower part of the screen, there's a poorly located USB port and an audio exit for earphones. These can be obtained at the cafeteria or with the attendant servicing this comfort cabin. ...180 km or 50 minutes into today's trip, we reach Valladolid Campo Grande, one of the most monumental stations in Spain, for a brief 2-minute stop. On the track next to ours, one of the 13 Renfe Class 114s arrived with an Avant service less than 15 minutes before us. These trains are very elegant, aren't they? Feeling the need to wash my hands before the complimentary meal service, I use the opportunity to show you the toilets. They are new, well-appointed and functional, with a large, sturdy baby-changing table. Back in my seat, I have my snack and an orange juice delivered to me. Meals for premium passengers are complimentary and can be ordered when purchasing the ticket. It consists of a vegetarian wrap, hummus with 1 carrot and 1 asparagus, and 1 small black chocolate. There are also 2 refreshing towels. I must say that this snack was very appetizing and quite welcome. I could have had a coffee delivered to the seat by the cabin attendant. However, as you know, I always enjoy having a little something in the cafeteria and my own version of food and scenery. If I had the coffee at my seat, it would have been complimentary. Having it at the bar, however, costs €2.60. Speaking of costs, I paid €61.25 for this trip, a very reasonable price, for a ticket purchased 18 days before traveling. Remember, though, that fares are dynamic and vary according to specific trains and time of purchase. One of the highlights of this trip is the tension and gauge changing facility just before León. Here, The train changes from the international 1435mm gauge to the Iberian 1668mm gauge, and also switches from the 25 kV alternating current used since Madrid to the 3000 V direct current used in the Spanish conventional network and from here to Gijón, all without stopping at a maximum speed of 15 km per hour. Shortly after, we stop at León's own signal due to a technical issue related to the infrastructure and traffic management. This stop lasts for 4 minutes. After that, we start moving again, very slowly, and come to a halt only 200 meters afterward. Here, we end up staying for 15 minutes. When the train starts moving again, we are already severely delayed. As a result, our arrival to León occurs with a delay of 21 minutes. León is an underground station that is quite unusual due to its skylights, each of which is in a different color, creating a unique and peculiar look. Do you like this aesthetic choice? Let me know in the comments below what you think of it. After León, the train keeps shaking and rattling, but worst is yet to come. At the end of the video, when I offer my comments about the trip, I won't forget to mention this issue. For now though, let's appreciate the series of bridges and tunnels until we reach the West Pajares Tunnel, a base tunnel stretching more than 24.5 km under the Cantabrian Mountains. This tunnel took 18 years to build and costs 3 billion euros. Trains pass it at around 200 km per hour. I can start now with the interiors by showing you the comfort class in a 2+2 configuration. If I'm honest, I'm not a fan of this setup. What do you think? Do you find it acceptable, or do you believe that a 2+1 configuration is more befitting of a first-class product for a long-distance train? After arriving in Gijón, and once all passengers have disembarked, I will show you the rest of the train. Do you remember the glorious weather in Madrid with the sun shining and the temperature of over 40 degrees Celsius? Well, after passing the Cantabrian Mountains, this is what we have, a winter day. As for the train, now that we have reached the conventional line, it shakes and rattles even more at a very moderate speed below 90 km per hour than it did at 300 km per hour in the high-speed line, where the ride was already quite rough when compared with other high-speed trains. Part of me still can't believe that Talgo produced and Renfe accepted this noisy cranking thing. When talking to a fellow passenger a moment ago, an elderly lady used to traveling by train, she mentioned that this isn't the AVE service she has known for years, neither the seats nor the overall comfort of the train. At 8:35 PM, we arrive at Gijón Sanz Crespo, our destination, with a 24-minute delay. As mentioned previously, now that the train is empty again, I will offer you a tour of its interior. There is ample space for luggage in both the luggage stacks and the large overhead racks. Due to these new cars being around 30 cm wider than previous Talgo generations, the manufacturer now offers new configurations with more seats. This includes a 2+2 configuration in first class and a 3+2 configuration in second class. Today, I was lucky enough to have my trip with no one else seated next to me. However, the 2+2 configuration in a first class cabin doesn't really convince me. Here, we have the 3+2 seating configuration in second class. If I ever end up in the middle seat, I won't be happy, that's for sure. This seating arrangement makes sense for low-cost services, but I'm not convinced it's ideal for mainline duties. What do you think of these configuration options? Do you like them? You don't mind? Let me know your preferences in the comments below. The new concept bar is the highlight of this train. It's bright, open, airy and very inviting. In addition to the standard options available on Renfe's services, there are even more food and drink choices available in the Avril, which is a plus. Finally, as I exit the train, it's time to share my impressions of today's trip while we spot the Class 106 departing to the depot. Let's start with the positives of this trip. It's fast, affordable, and Renfe's service is consistently good and welcoming. Additionally, the train has at least one positive aspect. It's beautiful, both inside and outside. However, there are several downsides. First and foremost, there's the issue of the delay on arrival. While it may not be Renfe's fault, it reflects on their service. The seats aren't very comfortable. The 2+2 seating layout isn't suitable for a first-class product. The ride quality is the roughest I've experienced on any modern Talgo train, and the train itself is very noisy. All of this raises the question, is this a train or a strange contraption with AVE stickers? Thank you for coming along on today's journey. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel and leave me a comment below. Your support is very helpful and indeed means a lot. Thank you for being here and see you next week.